I want to offer my thanks to the clergy and the congregations who have supported you all in your journey toward ordination. In fact, I would say that it's been a long journey. In fact, I need to rephrase it. It's been a long, long, long road.
Dear friends in Christ, you know the importance of this ministry and the weight of your responsibility in presenting Lisa and Lynn for ordination to the Sacred Order of Deacons. Is it your will that we ordain Lisa and Lynn as deacon?
It is.
Will you uphold them in this ministry?
We will.
My sisters, every Christian is called to follow Jesus Christ, serving God the Father through the power of the Holy Spirit. God now calls you to a special ministry of servanthood. My sisters, do you believe that you are truly called by God and His church to the life and work of a deacon?
I believe I am so called.
You now, in the presence of the church, commit yourself to this trust and responsibility.
I do.
Will you be guided by the pastoral direction and leadership of your bishop?
I will.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the reading and study of the Holy Scriptures?
I will.
Will you look for Christ in all others, being ready to help and serve those in need?
I will.
Will you do your best to pattern your life and that of your family in accordance with the teachings of Christ so that you may be a wholesome example to all people?
I will.
Will you in all things seek not your glory, but the glory of the Lord Christ?
I will.
May the Lord by His grace uphold you in the service He lays upon you.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Lisa. Fill her with grace and power, and make her a deacon in your church. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Lynn. Fill her with grace and power, and make her a deacon in your church. Please greet our new deacons.